Why is Clip Studio not here? That's odd. That's. Give me a minute to figure this out. So, hello, Grimmy. That's. Remove. Window capture. Why do you insist on doing this? That's really weird. It's not capturing Clip Studio. Game capture. This is not good. Me try reopen Clip Studio. That might fix things. Hopefully. Oh God, please fix things. There we go. Perfect. Okay, that's not right. Give me a second. Overlay. Bear with me. Deirdre, Miss Deirdre. Remove you. No clue why that happened. That is new. There we go. Well, there's today's scuff stream, scuff moment of the stream. If you're waiting for it, there it is. Just the whole art program not capturing. Okay. Well, now that that's out of the way, let's play some good old music. Might also have to, yeah, stream cord is fucking broken. Give me a second. Was weird. I just okay. Oh, I opened Valorant. That's why. Oh, hello, Elise. Hi, hi. How are you? Oh, Hello, love. Yeah, I actually took a nice day off yesterday, and I actually finished a good old romance anime yesterday, so that was nice. Right now, I'm basically because I've been spending a lot of time just watching anime instead of like working on art because I think I'm a bit burnt out. Because, yeah, for like most of September, I was like pumping out a bunch of art, rather like working on like big stuff, big pieces of art, like the two read run things. Oh God, I just realized I need to draw something Genshin. Yeah, those two redraws, I put my ass into that, and it's probably just about hit me that, oh God, I'm drained. I am mildly drained from those. Breaks are always important. Yeah, I'm gonna be heading to London for a few days, and probably that will be a forced break, more or less. Like, that is pretty much a forced break, but a break's a break. I just, I'm sorry. Yeah, the thing is though, it won't be for too long. It should only be for a few days. But yeah, I think I leave on Saturday, and it's about 3 or 4 days. I really don't want to go to London. I don't like it. Mainly because it just feels so tourist trappy, like tourist trap type area. Like, if you want to go anywhere, I would just not recommend London. As everything is just overpriced for no reason. There's nothing good about it. The only, actually, no, that's a lie. The only good thing about it is, conventions. That's it. Not gonna lie, conventions are the only good thing about London, and even then, it's still. But yeah, no, I won't be gone for 2 weeks like it was last time. Nah, this one will be a bit shorter. Still sucks that I have to go, but you know. I have forced 4 wishes currently. I am getting myself an Archon. Let's go! I have about 100. Oh shit, I forgot to condense my resin. I have about 100 resin. Not 100 resin, 100 wishes. She need an art break, I always need help in Genshin. Honestly, I want to stream Genshin, but for some reason my internet just really shits itself every time I do, so I'm kind of at the point where I'm like, okay, yeah, I guess not. Oh, for God's sake, I lost the original color. And like during my breaks, I've been just catching up on an old anime that I wanted to watch years ago. And it's been nice to finally watch them. Cause it's really weird, because when I do watch it, it feels like a part of my teenage brain is still there. Just happy that I'm finally watching these shows. It's nice. As per usual, I'm always a bit sleepy. More so today, because for some reason, I just don't feel like I rested properly. Like, my brain felt super active. And it's like, oh, okay. Yeah, no, I'm not getting proper sleep. And I kept waking up and all that stuff. It's like, okay, yep, I'm not getting to enjoy sleep today. Yeah, heads up, I also don't know if I'll be able to stream tomorrow, because I don't know if there's going to be packing. I still kind of partially refuse to go to London, so I'm not going to fucking pack. But yeah, no, there's a chance of no stream tomorrow. Just a heads up in that sense. I'm I love this song. I remember when the album came out, I was so hyped. And the lyrics, I read it and then... oh god, I need to... Oh gosh, I need to... Sure to do Genshin shit. I've learned that trying to do Genshin while not at my PC is painful, just simply because of the commissions. But you know what? I'm glad that if I'm going anywhere, it's in the UK, because I actually get to use my fucking data. Because fucking Brexit being all, oh no, no, you can't use your data abroad in England, that's not in the EU. Fuck you. I hate you. As you can tell, I am mildly... I'm very salty over it. I just want to use my... I have 15 gigabytes of data and it's like, oh yeah, no, I used to be able to use all that abroad. No, I can't. I'm sorry, I'm just, like, ranting, talking about whatever comes to my mind at the moment. But that's just kind of in the mood that I am. I don't know why, though. The thing is, just I'm just kind of rambling my own thoughts at the moment, which is probably it. Because I need to occupy my brain while I'm trying to do the most head-empty pattern. I told myself, oh no, I'm not gonna do the pattern. I'm not gonna do that. I won't do it, you know, because I don't want to do repetitive stuff. And then I did it anyway, because I have a drawing that I want to do actually. I want to work on this. I scribbled it down. I want to work on this. I can't, not until I finish this, because I don't want to leave this in work in progress hell. Hello, how are you? Hi, hi. Also, one thing I was wondering about, should I do like a dono goal? Like if we reach like it'll be a small one, but if I reach that dono goal, I will play a horror game. I will play Ib or something. May or may not be sitting on midterms right now. Oh god, good luck. You can do this. I believe in you. The present is I'm Gucci. Oh, okay, nice. And you bring up midterms reminds me of the fact that I just barely passed college. Like, I came, like, super dangerously close to failing. I need to make up for these last 2 weeks of not drawing. Oh god, I feel that. I feel that so bad. Because I remember during university, I didn't have time to do art for myself. But at the same time, I was still taking commissions because I needed, you know, money at the time. Mainly just for myself, but also to partially save up a bit afterwards. And oh God. And at college, I barely passed. Like, oh God, my grades were B, C, and D. It was horrendous. I've been working part-time this semester for the first and last time. Oh God, I remember I wanted to get a job. Yeah, I wanted to get a job, but my parents didn't want me to because it would like get in the way of them being able to book a holiday. And so I just never gained any work experience. And I think I'm gonna be paying for that now. I also remember I also wanted to get a job during university as well. But then the pandemic hit. And yeah, I couldn't get a job. I couldn't get a job because yeah, COVID. And like even after everything calmed down, because I'm considered high risk, I was like, okay, I am not gonna risk it. I won't risk trying to get a job, especially in such a busy city. I worked every semester except the COVID one interning, and my total GPA is around B plus. Oh, that's pretty good. Better than me, where I literally just barely passed with a D in one of my classes. I won't study though, too busy playing role. I remember, oh God. Like, university, I didn't. Sorry, give me a second. Oh shoot, the new YouTube Studio update's out. Okay, I need to check that out after. Anyway, yeah, no, for university, I took like an entirely like coursework only degree. And so because of that, I didn't have exams and all that. But there was still like essay writing and all that stuff, which was I'm the worst student discipline-wise. Oh, you don't know me. I was pretty bad, like it was. Oh, hydrate. I shout, Cobes. Hello. Let's check. I am sat up straight. My shoulder hurts from the way I was sleeping. It's not nice. Yeah, my first year of uni was. Oh God. The thing is, uni for me, I feel like I didn't. So my final studio presentation. Ooh. Not 15 minutes after I was doing Guilds. I remember the grind of. 1.5 bill. Oh God, I think I was like still in the. Where was I? I think I was still in the 140k side. Like top 140k part of Guild Wars. I wasn't even like top 80k. I wasn't even at that bit, so that was something. And then, what else? Worst part of college is like teachers signing readings. I'm glad I I'm glad my whole thing was like coursework because I really don't do well with exams. One thing I've noticed as of recent is I struggle to read. I had midterms exam this Tuesday. Oh god, how'd they go? It's fine, man. I'm not even spooked. Yeah, no, I've been reading a lot less and I hate it. Like, I've got manga sitting around that I need to read. I've got light novels I've not finished. I've got the Twilight Princess manga I've still not finished. I might do that while I'm in London, so we'll see. In studies, I deserve low score. You say low, but in university, that is actually a really good score, at least here. Like, 65 is like a pretty solid pass. And I think in college, it's also a pretty solid pass, depending on how well other people do. And it's my last year, so I just want to pass and get out. Yeah, I feel that. I did that with, what's it called? Uni. Yeah. 6 years passing here. Yeah. No, for university, for me, it was 4 years pass. And I scraped a pass, pretty much. Because one of my projects. Yeah. One of my projects. Yeah, but the thing is, the marking restrictions are also a lot stricter. Like, it's. Don't forget, this isn't like multiple choice and all that shit. No, you have to write it. Like, this is judged on, like, your artwork, the multiple iterations, how you've documented it, how you've evaluated it, how you've presented it. There's a lot of factors that come into play, how well it would work in your portfolio, how your portfolio is actually displayed, how it would look to an employer, all like little minor things. You know, all that stuff. Yeah, and there's a lot that goes into it, so yeah. Yeah, art degree. Pain. Thing is though, I'm not in the design field. Yeah, I'm as horrible as it all sounds, like the work I had to do and all that, I'm still glad that I did it because I did learn. I did learn techniques, I learned how to draw faster, I learned how to put more detail into my work, I learned the concept art pipeline, the production pipeline, I learned all these small things that can definitely help me. There's more objective grading in some of my classes, but I still have to make a portfolio. Yeah, portfolios. One day I will make a proper one, but for now my art station remains as my portfolio. Jesus, my wrist hurts. Okay. The thing is, I don't even think my wrist is hurting because of art. I think it's because of how I've been sleeping. Where I've had it like kind of folded and all that, because I wake up and like I keep waking up in the middle of the night, and my entire arm is numb and my wrist is in like the worst position it can be in, and it just hurts. Grieving yourself in your sleep. Yeah, I didn't even know that I moved around that much in my sleep and actually hurt myself that much in my sleep, but I guess so. And it's a weird thing of I need to be careful how I sleep, because if I sleep one way, I'm gonna trigger sleep paralysis. If I sleep another way, I'm gonna trigger my arm being numb and hurting myself. If I sleep another way, I end up like folding my ear somehow. And that hurts. So yeah, it's just really unfortunate that I just can't sleep properly no matter what I do. Really, that I sleep well. Yeah, I apparently sleep talk. I sleep attack. I am not a part of the normal sleeping majority. I sleep on my side but wake up on my belly. Sense. I find myself sometimes in like a stage of like being awake but also asleep. Like I'm aware of my surroundings and I move around. I move around accordingly. Like sometimes I'll like hear my mom. And then I'm like, oh, she's about to wake me up. And then she opens my door and comes and wakes me up. But I'm still in like a weird... Yeah, it's weird. Like something is probably wrong with me. I have always been like a super light sleeper though, so... Because the thing is, I've had sleep paralysis since I was a kid. Like, actual, like, 3 years old or so, I think I had sleep paralysis. Like, it was either sleep paralysis or, like, a really convincing nightmare. Like, I vividly remember it. Like, not even three, maybe, like, two. But I remember it so vividly because it stuck out so much. I remember I used to sleep in like a cot, basically like a big cot, in the same room as my parents. And I remember I woke up, it was still dark, it was the middle of the night. I didn't see, like I couldn't really... Oh no, it had to have been a dream, because I remember like it was just, I was looking up and I looked on like, sat on like the railing of my cot, there was like this little tiny green imp goblin looking type thing, and it was just trying to freak me out, and I was definitely reacting, so it had to have been a dream. Considering getting an art master's degree after I get my architecture degree, up to you really. I personally, I feel like just being able to find a course that can teach you the basics, the fundamentals, I feel like that's all you need, and building from that is all up to you. You don't need others to tell you how to do that. If it's anything like specific though, going, I need some structure in my painting learning. Yeah, that's where I'd say look more into a like fundamentals course. Because, okay, maybe not a full-blown master's. Yeah, exactly. Like, I feel like online courses would do you better for that. I feel like if you wanted to do something specific, like with how I did, because I did a degree in video game digital art. And from that, I learned like environmental layout. I learned how to make pre-visualizations for video games using Adobe After Effects. I learned concept art pipeline. I learned animation pipeline. I learned how to rig 3D models. I learned all that stuff just from 2 years of my degree. I learned design fundamentals in architecture school. Feel like I'm a bit above fundamentals. And like a few tools and techniques for digital painting. I feel like if that's the case, I'd recommend digital courses then. Like if you want to learn that, because I feel like a degree is not gonna teach you that stuff.
with my degree, they didn't really teach you how to do like digital art. They taught you how to use digital art in video games. That's all they taught you. They didn't like do the basics of that. I'll get a degree if my job pays for it for me. Yeah, if your job pays it, then do it. But otherwise, I'd recommend just stick with getting like an online course, maybe from like Ross Draws, Sam Dazar, you know, all them. What song can I play? Sure. Only thing I've drawn these past 2 weeks is a cat. That's fair. That honest, I think. Yeah, I spent an entire month not being able to draw for myself because of exams. Fuck, no more song. Okay, I gotta learn how to do backgrounds and landscape. Yeah, I love this song. Oh, it's a good cat! Oh my god. Oh my god. Post it in the server so I can actually properly show a proper big version. Actually, right, I should be able to just copy. I love it so much. Oh my god. Bruh. Not home, so I don't have the actual image. Okay. I'll post it sometime. Definitely, this looks so good. Oh my god, I love this. I love this so much. I love your brushwork as well. It's so good. Yeah, you better post it because I always love seeing your art. Funnily enough, I don't have the original song in my playlist. Same here. It's in my the two remixes in my YouTube playlist. Yeah. I'm so glad Project Sekai has brought up like so many good songs. So many like more underground songs and just also just given producers the ability to just show off more of their stuff. I love it. The Tokamix cover is adorable. Right, let's see if Twitch wants to mute this song or not, because they seem to not be able to figure out if they want to. It's really infuriating how inconsistent they are. Yeah, it's such a good song. It's not even copyright, because I have no problems posting the VOD on YouTube. Like, it doesn't get the VOD, my VOD, like, blocked on YouTube. Plus, I feel like this is fair use. It's not like I'm straight up re-uploading it. I'm using it as background music. It's no different from, like... It just annoys me. Such a good song. You'll see my attempts at people lift landscapes maybe after this weekend. Ooh, I can't wait to see you. Honestly, I definitely need to practice more on backgrounds. Because, like, at the moment, where's it gone? Yeah, my most recent drawing. I'm so proud of this background. And like, there's nothing more I'd want to add. Yeah, there's nothing more I'd want to add to this. But I want to be able to replicate this level repeatedly. And that's something I want to work on. And even just looking at it now, I am really happy with the improvements I've made over the years. And yeah, this is just it's a nice reminder of where I'm at. I'm rather inspired, but I feel crippled because the people I study got like special brushes for all that. Yeah, honestly. Sometimes you just need to accept and just use brushes. Just use like custom brushes. Or do you mean like specific textured brushes? Looking for a brush to make clouds. Oh, I have one brush that I did use. Let's see if I can find a piece where I used the brush. Yeah, this one I used, the other one's very... Oh, this one, like for these clouds. It's not the best brush, but I used like a watercolor-ish brush. It's not perfect, but I like the little texture it makes. I'll have to say fuck it and learn to make my own, yeah.
Hello, Abby. Hi, hi. Feeling a bit mischievous because my PDF recitation for the midterm was 140 megabytes. Jeez. Jeez, what you got in there? You're working with AI gen- the images are kinda intense. Man, AI art makes me sad. One of the trending tabs on Pixiv was novel AI, which is a program people are using to make, or at least the program for AI generated art. And people are using it and it just makes me sad. Yeah. And the thing is, it's littering Pixiv. And one of my friends, he posted art, and he didn't even realize it was AI art until I posted it out because I noticed the hashtags, and one of them was novel AI. And it just made me kind of upset and also kind of mad because, yeah, people are posting this like it's there are. And there was the recent drama with they might have been baiting, but also I don't know, but that one with the Raiden drawing, like the thing that happened recently with the Raiden drawing and the person who was streaming it, and then their work in progress got nabbed and some dude finished it like 4 hours before they finished the drawing, and it was like, oh, give me credit. Give me credit. Fuck off. Actual dickhead. Yeah, as you can tell, I do not like AI art. There's very few exceptions. Very, very few exceptions. And that is like an artist that I follow, Wani. She uses the AI art to like sort of, with inspiration, she'll type in prompts, it will give like a very vague looking pose, and from that she interprets it. And that I really liked. That I absolutely loved. But when people are making like the level of novel AI and using that, or like Midsummer, is that, I think it's called. Midjourney. Like, yeah, with Midjourney, that level. It just makes me kind of upset that people are trying to use that as like, oh, I'm an artist. No, you're not. You're getting a machine to do it for you. Like, okay. You may think you're an artist, but when someone commissions you and they want you to change one slightly specific thing, good luck doing that, fucking shithead. Yeah, there's my AI art tangent. I feel very passionately about this topic. Yeah, I don't know if
who saw on my server, but this year I'm hopefully gonna do my best to participate in Thankmas, the charity event that Jacksepticeye hosts every year. Like, this year, now that I'm finally streaming, I want to participate. And I want to help raise some money. I remember looking last year and I was like, oh god, this actually looks really fun. And like, I'd actually be able to do something. Forgot to mention also, one part of AI art that really pisses me off is just the stolen art aspect, that it trades off of stolen art. That's also what I really dislike about it. I was reminded of the existence of the Evilist series. The Evilist Chronicles, rather. It's like, okay, now I just have to play them because some of these songs are good. And some of them I can't play because, you know, Gakpo, you know. Hello. Don't you love group work meetings? Oh, no, I don't. Project for one of my classes is setting up a display at the nearby art center for the Light Festival in December, and I haven't heard back from most of them. Oh, jeez.
Well, good luck.
That does not sound fun at all. Why did I take the glove off? My brain is laggy, I think. Booba shading. I'm sure it right behind me just now. Oh. Great timing. Yeah, love to see it. A bit of a release if I don't know what we're doing. Well, good luck there. Did Monty never upload the full Eblis series? I want to do a painting.
I believe in you. This song came out in 2008.
I am old. I'm so old. The song is Daughter of Evil. Yeah, it came out 2008. Which is old by Vocaloid standards. I'm getting there. What the song is. My god. Oh, another streamer I was watching had a nostalgia music playlist on. Yeah, you want to feel old? Gangnam Style is 10 years. 10 years? 12 years? 10 years? 10 years old. What I was doing the first time I heard Gangnam Style. Oh. I remember I was in class when someone brought it up. And I heard it and I was like, oh, this is catchy. Season 2 League of Legends Jungle Warwick clearing boob. I love that. I love how specific you are. God, League is that old.
I don't know, but even back then, even I had heard of League of Legends, and I wasn't even that much of a gamer. I was just a Nintendo gal. I forgot how long this song is. I was telling my brother who still plays last night, he mains Ahri. Nice. Is this Servant of Evil? I can't read it because it's in Japanese and I do not read. Please tell me it's Servant of Evil because I cannot tell. Yes, it is. You should learn Moon Runes. I wish. I'm still struggling to learn German. And my teacher keeps forgetting he's my teacher. I can't read Japanese text, but I can read katakana. I can't even do that. Figure out names of songs and such. That's convenient. Matt, you bringing that up reminded me of someone who was in my high school. They claimed to be like part Japanese, and like I believe them because you know they didn't know Japanese. But also, sometimes they just said stuff that didn't exactly I guess fit. Like how typically with like when you're being polite you will say like you'll refer to someone by their surname and all that and have the suffixes afterwards. And then I remember they were like, no, you only like with names. Like Kun and all that. I was like, I don't remember what we were discussing, but
I remember they were like, no, what? Why are you saying that? That's how you're... are you calling them an old man? I was like, no. But sure, that's not even right. It was... And then they were like, you only refer to, like, little children with Chan. I was like, okay, yep. We have names and those honorifics are far over my head. Yeah, honorifics, that's the word. I can read the names of Granblue characters in Japanese, it's so helpful. That is honestly handy. Yeah, no, that is really convenient. Can't believe I'm struggling to speak my own language. I can't speak. We suffer together. Oh. This is a throwback. Wait, no, it wasn't Waltman. Yeah. I change my family if I speak more of a different variant of my native language than my native language. No, I don't think so. By native, do you mean like my first language or my mother tongue? Mother tongue, that's a tricky one. It's a very specific, language belonging to a certain state in India. So it's that, but the thing is, I'm in a very awkward position where I can fully understand it. I can fully understand when someone is speaking to me, but I can't speak it. Give me a phrase, I can give you a response in English, but I can't speak it myself. And it's been a huge point of shame for me as well, kinda. Because my parents always give me shit, like, what are you gonna do when you marry? How are you gonna talk to your in-laws? Because they assume that I'm gonna marry someone from the same state. Not happening, but, you know, I can let them hope. I have, like, 80% comprehension of my mother tongue, same. It's like, as a secondary, it would also have to be like Hindi or something, because that's also something that they speak a lot over in India. I also don't understand that, because I just don't understand it. My family speaks Cantonese. Oh, I cannot. I speak more Mandarin than Cantonese. Ah, honestly, I feel like that's fair. Say that's too much then. The thing is though, I don't know too much. Well, I can speak much of either. You know, I don't know too much of the differences between Mandarin and Cantonese. But I imagine, actually no, I can't even imagine. I am curious though, like, in China, like, what is, like, spoken more? What is it, like, a region-based thing? Same characters, different pronunciations? Oh, okay. And, like, a bit of different grammar? And, like, is it, like, is there a context where you would use one over the other type of thing? Oh, I've heard about tones. Oh god. Oh, oof. Yeah, sounds about right. Different dialects like India. Ah, regional. Okay. That makes a lot of sense. Mandarin is enforced as the national language when communism took over. Okay. That's a nice history lesson. Oh, Cantonese regional dialect of the southern part of China. It's like a kind of region in Hong Kong, but they learn Mandarin in school nowadays there.
Hmm.
Interesting, interesting. I've only been to China once.
How was it?
Hot. Oh god. Yeah, I imagine. Yeah, I imagine pollution isn't going to do favours when it comes to, like, the weather. It's going to make it, like, so much more stuffy because, like, it's all, like, pollution's going to the clouds, it's trapping heat, it's very much not helping. It was looking like a 720p, but IRL? Oh no. Oh god. Oh god. The thing is, I feel that though, because when I went to India, I went in winter, right? I went in like Christmas. It was Christmas time. Christmas to New Year's. Winter, right? 40 degrees Celsius. Let me convert that to Fahrenheit real quick for Americans. Celsius, Fahrenheit. 104 degrees. It was 104 degrees Fahrenheit when I went in winter, Christmas time. Winter. Bro, I was sweating. It was so bad. Now, the thing is, Australia actually does get cold winters. But where I was living, where I was at the time, it was not cold. It was so bad. That plus just the streets there were really dirty. Oh, yeah, hot Christmas, yeah. Gonna blend that later. I guess I'm not very well traveled outside the US. The thing is though, you've gone outside the US, so you're already better than most of the population. Been to a handful of states. Yeah, I'd definitely say you're better than most Americans already if you've been outside the states. So, yeah. But only Canada and China internationally? Again. Better than most. Did you know, Luna, that if you eat, your tummy won't be empty? Hello, Gabrielle! Hello, good evening. How are you? Yeah, I had a good dinner. I ate cabbage. Okay, but the average American, well, lives in a small town in, like, Iowa or something. I'm an immigrant child. I feel like immigrant children have the advantage because they actually know that places outside of America exist. Bad, I have a cold. Oh no! Just when I got better from my cough, kinda. For some reason, my cough flares up when I play Valorant. So I'm being very careful right now. And not yelling and playing Valorant. The only play is that... I can learn if passing it to me. No! The only places that the average American know exist are Vietnam, Afghanistan, and Iran. And Mexico, yeah. And they still assume that they're all in the United States. Like, I want to give Americans credit and that they are smart, but God, my For You page is plagued with Americans not being able to point out where Russia is. Okay, we had a productive, awesome luncheon today. We had an awesome luncheon today. Was a productive day. That's good to know. It's nice to have a productive day. I've been having more of a lazy day. Been watching some romance anime. Yeah, I've not done much other than just watch romance anime because I love cheesy 2010s romance anime. What did I watch? I was watching Blue Spring Ride. Anyone who's familiar with older anime may recognize the lead. He's not a strong suit. I gotta get some work done, so I'll catch you around sometime. Okay. Thank you for popping in, Ryu. Yeah, this is the anime that I watched. I love it to bits. It's very much 2010 to 2017 romance anime. And I love it to bits. And like, I was watching it. There were some scenes that just reminded me why I love this era. There was one scene in particular. I think my sister saw that. Oh my god. One scene that got me was she was hooked to it. Yeah, I want to read the manga. I want to read the manga. And yeah, this scene here got me so hard. I love it so much. I was screaming kiss. I was because the thing is, they've had so many like proper romancy moments. There's another one I want to find because it was like proper fangirl screeching. Oh god, where is it, please? Let me find it. Because are you boring MC? The thing is, the girl's the MC. But yeah, no, this is what happens right after. And my soul escaped my body. My soul left my body when that happened. She kisses the back of his head. I was squealing. Oh god. Because the thing is, it's always going to be, because it's shoujo romance anime, it's always going to be a female lead. Now kids. I love the anime so much.
Be like Deirdre and meet a total random dude and fall in love at first sight. But you know what? They did more than most romance animes that end up being super mid-tier. Because at least this scene happened. I'm annoyed that they didn't get a season two in because they were definitely setting up for a season two. They were definitely trying to set up for a season two. But it just didn't happen, I guess, because they just couldn't get it. It'd be like that, unfortunately. But because of that, I'm gonna definitely read the manga. The timing. Morpheus step bro, let's not. Oh, this brings me pain. You know, I'm gonna be moving on to Magic Kaito, which I've not seen in years, but I remember distinctly because of the opening. Let me find it. Oh, this preparing his barbecue, please no. This song. I remember I found this song on Nico Nico Doga years ago. It was a cover, and I don't know who covered it, which makes me sad because I don't think I'll ever find it again. I love Honeyworks' music because it's always so good. Gonna hit bed, see you tomorrow. Love you all. Thank you, Poppy and Gabrielle. Have a good sleep. I appreciate it as always. I was watching back on some of my VODs and I realized, wow, it desyncs. Sometimes the music will just desync and that makes me kind of sad because I don't know how to fix that. Oh,
Yeah, I think the sleeve is done. I just need to blend it out later.
What's a bit of shading from the hair falling down there?
My eye feels like there is a hair in it.
That's not nice. What was I looking for?
I just realized I don't think I've ever listened to the Japanese version of Drifting Soul. I think it's time to fix that. What do you think about this?
Oh, Riffing soul. Oh, is it just that there's no Japanese version of it? I guess not. Reaches out so far. Oh well, not mine. What would I be wanting till I reach the end of paths to see? I would keep thinking, questioning to myself, why do I have to walk this path? Oh, why? I don't seem to find the real meaning to this. Path that I take faith to accept, and my goal seems so far away. So tell me why I'm here and what's the reason I am here today. I recall it was you wish that I would stay. No matter how much we were going to, I will keep on. I will keep moving on. Find the answer to I'm lost in search for you. I'm tired from the cost to carry on. Shine that I can't see a way ahead. What the fear of the place so gently in the air, and melts as time just passes by. When I look back, there is no trace of my path. I cannot find my way to the past, and it's just too late. No reason lasts, I'm so lonely. Now the ghost on me and out. My eyes see ahead. So tell me why I'm here and what's the reason I'm here today. If I call up this fear, you wish that I would stay. How much we will blow against me. I'll keep on. I will keep moving on. Finally set to you. Lost in search for you. Stop and look ahead and face up to the blue above. Change the flywheel. Calm down and jump away. If I could climb up to the top, would you be willing to talk to me? I said no more. I'll try and try the yes, there, the distance of the voices.
I think it's about that time where I go ahead and end off stream. I think I've made some solid progress today. And I'm feeling a little bit tired right now. So we are going to raid this lovely person here. Lovely, lovely person. Thank you so much everyone who came by for today's stream. Thank you, thank you. I appreciate it as always. Tomorrow, I don't know if I will stream. Maybe I will? We'll find out. But I'll try my best. No promises, though. Be sure to stick around for the raid, show them some love in the chat, all that good stuff. Thank you so much, and I'll see you hopefully tomorrow, and if not, sometime next week. We'll see. Bye-bye.